So, just going to tell you a little bit about why the song is, why does it sound so crappy, and how it all come together. And I had borrowed a realistic Concertmate 660, which is a horrible, horrible little keyboard from the late 80s or early 90s. And I thought, well, let me see if I can make a song with it. And given the challenges of its limited dynamic equalization range, just see what we can do. And so the inspiration behind the song itself came from like mid to late 80s kind of police or detective action dramas. And so if you think like about 10 minutes before the episode ends, they're getting in the car to go do something, arrest the bad guys or whatever it is, their cover's blown. And this would be kind of the music that we'd be playing. I just chose some city stuff to show for the video, just so there's something to look at. And so process started the rhythm section off of the Concertmate. It's horrible sounding, very limited dynamically, not much lows. The highs are basically non-existent above 5 or 6K. And so I brought it into the computer and used Waves Factory Quantum to open it up and give it some dynamics, a little bit of EQ, and then into Mr. Wiggly's Incinerator to help give it some life. And so I think that process of those few plugins really opened up those drums. I mean, they still sound crappy, but about 1,000 times better than they did just the raw signal. Also use some other presets off of there. Human voice, I think, is the pad sounds, and there's an organ sound, which also ran through IQ Multimedia Leslie on the pad. Main effects were chorus, reverb, and Pulsar Modular's fixed filter bank. And I use that for some EQ because you just got to take out some of the mud off of this keyboard. And then also with that plugin, you can separate things into the stereo field, and so it just widens it, makes it sound a little bit better. In addition to those things, bass guitar and three guitar tracks. There's a distorted rhythm in the middle of it, but the clean rhythm and the solo come from the plugins you see on the screen there. By the way, dig my Spinal Tap poster up there. And so the lead comes from, these are both actually based, say hello to Sola. They're both based on the Rockman unit, which was created by Tom Scholz of Boston. And so if you can imagine it, you know, these little units were solid state battery powered, like kind of headphone amplifiers, or you could use them direct to board. And they have a really terrible sound, to be honest, but they have such a narrow range that they just kind of fit into a mix in an interesting way. And so you would hear them on like the Boston records. Of course, Satch used them. And then my favorite example is the Hysteria album by Def Leppard. A lot of the clean guitars. In fact, the title track Hysteria for the clean rhythm stuff at the beginning. Really showcases a sound. So I use the IK Multimedia version, which is that darker blue one. And then the lighter blue is the THU. And I hadn't had any of their plugins, and so this is the first one, but it was nice because it adds more modules than what the it's more like the rack mount version, where the IK Multimedia is more the handheld, you know, little pack. So had some fun with those tracks and mixed it up. And there's a little bit of saxophone, and that's about it. And so, you know, the limited dynamic range of the keyboard and of the Rockman, I thought would be perfect for kind of like a TV show type of soundtrack, you know, vibe to this. And so, yeah, I mean, that's basically it. And you know, just want to do something for fun. And you know, this is basically, you know, just a shits and giggles track. You know, it's easy to record things with really nice, you know, guitars and synthesizers, but there's an opportunity to, you know, try to polish a turd, so to speak, with this realistic concert made. And so, anyways, hope you enjoyed it.